To get started, I'm going to add some canola oil to the pan so that it can get hot. That's going to prepare it for the fish. While that's happening, I'm going to put in a combination herb spices for my tomato and caper sauce. That includes chives, tarragon, and flat leaf parsley. This is very popular with the Mediterranean style dish. While that is simmering, I'm going to go ahead and prepare the fish. This is lemon sole, and this particular fish, as you can hear the oil frying there, this particular dish is very popular Mediterranean style simply because they pride themselves on fresh fruits and vegetables, as well as fish. Okay. Now this will only take a few minutes because it does not take long for a white fish to cook. This is a lemon sole, and because it's such a soft fish, the time will be reduced. All right. While that's happening, I'll check on my sauce here, where all the flavors should be blended in by now. Now for the Mediterranean food, you notice that they pride themselves on olives and olive oil. They also pride themselves on a lot of grains, such as couscous, in addition to hummus, as well as other just earthy type grains, all right? The other thing I'm going to do is add a little red pepper flake the sauce. That's going to give it a nice little kick when I get ready to plate this up. Alright, I wish you could smell it. It smells really good. Add additional seasonings. And I'll just warm this up just a bit while the fish is cooking. This should be ready to turn right about now. Now you'll notice that a lot of the Middle Eastern stores have, the restaurants rather, will have hummus, kibbeh, and other foods of that nature. Ah, that has nice color to it. Looks good. As I mentioned earlier, it does not take very long for the fish to cook. This fish has already been seasoned, and we're just about ready to plate up. As you will see from my plate here, you will notice that I've also included other Mediterranean dishes, specifically the couscous, which has lemon and mint combined. Also kale, again stressing the importance of fresh vegetables for the Mediterranean and Middle Eastern culture. Now for this fish, we'll just plate this up. I'll bring that out. And what you'll see here, tomato sauce along with capers. And there we have it. That's my Mediterranean whitefish with tomatoes and capers.